is that aftermath of the elementary school massacre in Uvalde, Texas, as it continues to unfold, what we are now focusing on is law enforcement's response or lack thereof. We have new footage that's emerged during the attack that really shows that there were a lot of frustrated onlookers, parents, and members of the community urging police officers to charge into that Texas elementary school where the gunman's rampage killed 19 children and 2 teachers. Now watch this footage here. Those harrowing screams from people wanting to get to their children. As you can imagine, that this would be a very innate human response to want to rescue your child. And it's an utterly heartbreaking scene outside of that school. But the thing is that we saw that the officers were preventing people from entering the building, and that was very difficult for them to watch, especially because the officers, they had out their tasers, and some of them, as you saw, had their guns on display. And they were ready to stop the parents from saving their own children, as we see in the picture there. And it really also does appear that one of the officers also had a parent pinned to the ground. This is what we know from the AP News. "Go in there, go in there," nearby woman shouted at the officer soon after the attack began, said Juan Carranza, 24 years old, who saw the scene from outside his house across the street from Robb Elementary School in the close-knit town of Uvalde. Carranza said the officers did not go in. Javier Cesarez, whose fourth grade daughter, Jacqueline Cesarez, was killed in the attack, said that he raced to the school when he heard about the shooting, arriving while police were still gathered outside the building. And upset that police weren't moving in, he raised the idea of charging into the school with several other bystanders. "Let's just rush in because the cops aren't doing anything like they are supposed to," he said. "More could have been done. They were unprepared," he added. And minutes later, Carranza had watched as Salvador Ramos, the shooter, crashed his truck into a ditch outside the school, grabbed his AR-15 style semi-automatic rifle, and shot at 2 people outside a nearby funeral home who ran away uninjured. Now, Carranza said that the officers should have entered sooner, adding, "There were more of them. There was just one of him." Now, officials say that Ramos encountered a school district security officer outside the school, though there were conflicting reports from authorities on whether the men exchanged gunfire. After running inside, he fired on 2 arriving Uvalde police officers who were outside the building, said the Texas Department of Public Safety spokesperson Travis Considine. The police officers were injured. And we also know that 19 children were murdered here and 2 teachers. And so there are so many questions here in terms of why law enforcement did not enter that building, why they did not do anything for approximately 40 minutes, especially as we now know definitely that 40% of that city's budget is going to law enforcement. And so there's so many questions about what wasn't done and why wasn't it done. John, how does this sit with you?
It makes me incredibly uncomfortable. I mean, I could hear it in your voice coming out of that video, like listening to those parents, and you know, because we're not hard right wingers, you can't watch a video like that and not mentally cast yourself into their position and think about how they must be feeling, listening to gunshots and wondering if your child just died, wondering why nothing is happening as minute after minute goes by, wishing that you could run in there to save your own kids. And we're finding out now, apparently from one of the officials in the area, that when some of the cops finally did go in, some of them went specifically to get their own kids from inside. So they seem to understand where the parents are coming from, the desire to make sure that your child is safe. And yet they weren't rushing in. They were apparently, I think, understandably terrified of going up against someone who is wielding such a deadly weapon. The issue is, though, that's the job that you sign up for. We all have things about our jobs that we don't like. I don't like covering stories like this. It makes me feel terrible for humanity, but it's your job, and so you do it. If you don't want to have to go up against armed shooters, don't become a cop. Don't go into law enforcement. And don't go in there apparently being unwilling to do what's necessary. And by the way, as we said on the damage report this morning, I don't want them to be facing these sorts of situations. I don't want them to have to go up against someone wielding those deadly firearms. Then help us become allies. Cops everywhere could go on strike until there's common sense gun regulation. If they don't want people to have armor piercing bullets and high capacity magazines and weapons like AR-15s and AK-47s and all that, they could make it an issue that the right wouldn't be able to run from. But unfortunately, they generally haven't been our allies in that. And so we end up in this position where they'll be going up against people with weapons at least as deadly as their own. Mm-hmm. But we still expect them to do their job.
Yeah, and we're seeing that that's where 40% of the Uvalde, that area budget goes to law enforcement, and that's what they're spending it on, having as much artillery as its public and citizens have, despite the fact that the citizens don't need it. There is nothing militarized that needs to be necessary about our civilian population, yet by virtue of having these guns readily available and accessible to people, it's going to continue to create these situations where law enforcement are afraid to go against civilians because they are militarized and armed. And it's just this cyclical sense of nonsense. And it is something that we have people who could be held accountable for them, for this situation, including one of them, who is the Department of Public Safety, the director, Steve McCraw. And this is his picture here. Now, McCraw told reporters that 40 minutes to an hour elapsed from when Ramos, the shooter, opened fire on the security officer to when he was shot. Although a department spokesperson later said that they couldn't give a solid estimate for how long the shooter was in the school or when he was killed. McGraw said, quote, "The bottom line is law enforcement was there. They did engage immediately. They did contain Ramos in the classroom." And what we're definitely seeing now out in the public is this effort to rehabilitate law enforcement, to show that they are useful and utilitarian in this moment where you do have an active shooter. We've seen this, we have a New York Times article that just came down this morning that is something that kind of says the police officers did their best and that they were the ones actively working. And they even start the article by saying that most of the children were already dead by that time.
Yeah.
This is disgusting, John.
It just seems like I don't know what it's like. I you know, as bad as all this looks, I feel this probably needless, self-destructive need to not be overly judgmental before we know literally everything, even acknowledging that the cops have actively deceived people about multiple elements of the story already. I don't know exactly what it must be like to know that you're supposed to go in there and apparently not be willing to do it. But the feeling coming out of this, it just seems like the cops were so largely irrelevant. It seems like the shooter did basically what he wanted. Maybe he had grander plans. I don't know. It's impossible to say. But we should be able to expect, especially considering the massive amount of resources that are going into these police departments, so that they can handle a situation like this.
Absolutely. And unfortunately, we are going to see more situations like this until there's change.